What is up, guys? Mr. The Reverts here, and today I want to talk to you guys about something that has rubbed me the wrong way, even more so with Call of Duty Modern Warfare, because if you want a tiny little feature that's been in every single Call of Duty game since the beginning, then it's going to cost you a ridiculous amount of cash to have it. Let's check it out. So as you already know, there is absolutely no way for you to check how many deaths you have while playing in a game, which is completely confusing to me because as a player, I do kind of want to know how I'm doing in a game, but really the only logical explanation I can think of as to why they removed it is because that way you won't be thinking, oh, I got to perform well and get a good KD. That's the only way I'm going to have fun. And at the same time, this does benefit those players who might not be so skilled at the game, but regardless, that's another conversation for a later video. However, there is a way for you to check how many deaths you have in a game, but it's going to cost you a stupidly high amount of money, $20 to be exact, to get this watch called the Time to Die from the Mother Russia in-game bundle. Now, granted, you do get a couple of other in-game items like an operator skin, some blueprints, and other cosmetic changes, but for $20 or 2,000 COD points, I think that is way too damn high. And to be honest, really the only thing I care about are those blueprints and the in-game watch. Like, I do want to know how I'm doing in the game because it's going to tell me, do I need to perform better or is this game filled with a lot of sweats? You know, it's stupid that they removed that little feature in a game that's been in every single Call of Duty game for years now, but then later go around and add a way for you to actually check that stat, but you have to pay $20 for it. I mean, I would be okay with not having a death counter in the leaderboards, fine, whatever. I do understand the other side of the argument too, because Infinity Ward probably wants to add more emphasis on objective play, which again is an issue in Call of Duty for sure, but the issue underneath all of that is you allow that feature to be in a game, but you gotta pay $20 for it. Or if you'd want to, just save up the COD points from the battle pass if you're fortunate enough to actually have the time to level up through those tiers. But again, it's that principle of adding an issue to the game where the fans are actually upset about and voicing this to you, but then the idea to remedy this issue by adding a feature that costs 2,000 COD points for it is wrong in itself. So creating an issue and then selling you the fix, that's what I do not like in this game whatsoever. I truly don't think that Infinity Ward will ever add a death counter to the leaderboards as of now. In fact, I do not even see them making any major changes to the core game itself at all. Like for the minimap, I don't see that being changed and other stuff, but I do definitely see a trend like this starting, creating an issue and then selling you the fix. For $20, that was about the price of a DLC pack in previous Call of Duty games, but now that $20 equates to a bunch of in-game cosmetic items. It's just crazy to me to see how much Call of Duty has changed over the years with microtransactions and the in-game store. So I want to know, what do you guys think about this? Do you have an issue with this watch or the fact that you can't see your deaths in-game, but you can if you spend $20 on a watch? Again, I want to know your opinions down below in the comments. Also, drop a like on the video if you guys did enjoy, and thanks so much for watching. Love y'all so much. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Till next time, I'll see you later.